Hello and welcome back to Astroneer with me, Bardon. So we're here on the moon, and what I've decided to do is I want to go have a look at what's in this direction. So I'm just gonna get to the top of the rise, yeah, and just point at random things, and let's start running. And you see, we got the planet we came from over there. So we got some interesting research over here, and I don't know what this thing is. But yeah, this is definitely worth exploring. So let's head back. Oh, we got something over here as well. Look, it's nice. So let's get ourselves back to base. We'll definitely get there before we suffocate, which is nice. Okay, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to start tethering out in this direction. So the first thing I need to do is use some of this compound to make some new tethers. Okay, then let's make a new set. Okay, and two should be enough. So let's leave our compound here. The good thing about the moon is that we don't ever seem to experience any storms here. So it means that our stuff won't blow away the way it did on our starting planet. Okay, so then let's start tethering our way up the hill. So we're going to veer slightly in this direction so we can get to that deposit. Okay, and then what we've got here. So it's malachite. So it's going to be malachite is the one that turns into copper, I think. Because that's what my memory is telling me. So we're gonna sell some nice copper here. It looks like a deep deposit as well. Okay, now let's see if there's any more. There certainly is. That might be it. Okay, so let's start refilling. And just because the moon is already full of craters doesn't mean that we get to leave ours behind. And then it should be high enough now to start using the smoothing tool. Maybe that piece isn't okay, so let's build up around here a bit more and then take from there. And let's take from this side. I think this game would be interesting if, or it is interesting, but maybe a little bit more interesting if there were more than just environmental hazards. So maybe if there were some kind of enemies. I don't know whether the developers have that in mind for the future or not, but it would be certainly something interesting to see. Now, I have seen Morjax's on Morjax's playthrough where he's on a different planet he's on the next planet from this one, and the problem he's having is that there are constant storms, and the and at all times it seems he's under siege from spiky balls instead of the cubes of death from the original planet. There's like spiky balls instead. You know, the next planet that we go to, which is that one, is certainly not going to be as peaceful as it is here on the moon. Okay, and now I want to get back because my oxygen will be running out. And there are a lot. Wow, can actually climb up the spike. Lucky you didn't impale me on the way down. Let's take you, and then let's try to maneuver around the spikes. I do like the lower gravity here as well. Let's get ourselves a nice, let's get ourselves a nice screenshot for the thumbnail, but I'm not sure a screenshot of our dead body because we suffocated would be so good. Maybe some people would enjoy it, but I don't think I would. Okay, so let's get ourselves, that's nice, up in the air a bit. Okay, and then we grab that one as well. Okay, let's move her away over here. Okay, now I want to just quickly have a run over here and see if there's something interesting that I want to take. So there's some power there. I'm gonna take the red cube, just because I have a good feeling about the red cube. So let's take that if we can. Apparently we can't. Okay, not sure why, but I don't want to suffocate, so let's get going. Have I lost my bearings? Yeah, a little, but I'm pretty sure I'm supposed to be going in this direction. Okay, so we're good. Now let's start moving these guys back. Okay, so what's happening? For whatever reason, I can't now interact with these. Oh, there we go. So I think equipping my tool and unequipping it seemed to fix whatever that was. Basically, left clicking on them was doing nothing. Now it is, so that's good. So let's start moving all of this stuff back. That one can go a bit further on. I am still very interested to see where this game goes in the future, because there's certainly plenty of potential. For the moment, the fact that a lot of the, or should I say all of the all of the resources in the game seem to be obtainable from the start, as long as you've got your trade platform, and then obviously you can get them from research as well. you know, I'm not sure, you know, how wise that was. Now, at least from the way I'd like to play, I'm sure a lot of other players appreciate the access to the rare materials easier than having to go and find them. But you know, it would be kind of a compelling reason to have to go to other planets if there were resources there that you just couldn't find on your own planet and you couldn't trade for as well. Now, I'm sure that there are probably technologies from the from these research on different planets that are maybe either exclusive to a certain planet or maybe exclusive to a certain tier of planets, which again would be a reason to go to other planets. But you know, it's always nice to kind of feel like that there's, you know, that there's progress there to be made, not just that you kind of, you know, it's like giving someone access to, you know, everything in an MMO from the start. You know, that it kind of it takes away one reason for continuing to play, you know, because for me, a big thing about this game is that you know, the whole thing of what's over that hill, you know, what's around that corner, what's down that hole. That's the reason why I started playing this game in the first place, and I hope that there are more things like that, like these research here. I'm excited to see what's in them, especially the green and red one, because from one like a similar one to that, we actually got some new stuff here. So we just have to get this stuff on the far side. Go. So let's start moving it across. We'll leave the one that potentially could be something new until the end. We'll probably start with the brick type ones, then go to the green and red ones, and then finally, the dark green and red ones, should I say, and finally to the kind of the this one here, the yellowish and red one as well. Okay, so let's start with this guy. I'm expecting maybe just resources. Yep, so it's some lithium. So that's nice because, you know, batteries are never a bad thing when power is in, you know, I wouldn't say short supply because as you saw, we were able to recharge that pretty quickly. But I think, our battery is recharging anyway, so I think we should be okay. Let's just move a bit closer, so we can grab this one and stick it on there. Okay. Again, I'm pretty sure that is, yes, some more resources, so some aluminium there. And let's put this guy on. Okay, then there's some hydrazine. Let's put you on there and get you started. Some copper. Okay, and I'm expecting more resources from this one as well. And then some more aluminium. Okay, now this one potentially could be some research. Or some technology, should I say. But no, it's some resin. So that's a bit of a bit of an anticlimax here with that one. Okay, so what I'm gonna do now is go ahead looking for, wow, it's a bit of a hole there. Go ahead looking for some more of the research. So we've got this cluster over there. So now let's start tethering our way in that direction. We can also grab the malachite or malasite on the way. So let's get our tool out. It's not gonna take too long either to explore all the moon because it's so small compared to the previous planet, and it's probably smaller or probably maybe equivalent to the site, the area that we already explored on the planet that we came from. And in terms of that planet, that wasn't very much, but here on the moon, that kind of exploration could probably cover most of the surface at least. Let's grab this here if we can. There we go. How close are we to another stack? Well, we're very close. And then I was going to fill it in, but maybe I can find one more before we do. It's potentially on this side as well. Yeah, there we go. But still, we need maybe another one. Okay, so there. Okay, now we can start filling in. Okay, let's get rid of you. Start smoothing. Oh, we need to do there as well. Okay, let's do that. And then we can start maybe smoothing from here. Then around that guy as well. Okay, that's fine. And then just here beside us as well, actually. Okay. Now let's start heading towards more of this lovely research. And down there seems to be another cave. I'm just gonna have a quick look down here. Expecting more spikes, and certainly what we got. Okay, so then there's probably more resonant compound down there if we wish to brave the spikes again, but right now my focus is on getting some more research. And you can see how small the planet is because we came from that direction. But our home is now in that direction. And it's because of the curvature of the planet. So let's grab these guys. So this red one is the one that I've got high hopes for. For no particular reason. Just because. And then you and you are the ones that are probably going to give us some nice stuff. or should I say potentially rather than probably. Okay. One behind. One hiding behind him. Okay, you're the last guy. Okay. So there's more research over in that direction as well, which you'll probably get on another expedition. So let's start moving these ones back again. Our lovely relay technique. So tempted just to run rather than take this circuitous route that we've built for ourselves, but I'm not going to do it right at the moment, at least. And then the two, potentially the two important ones. And there we go, there's the sun coming up. Blinding as it is. Okay, now we can start going this way. So part of the reason why the angle changes to our base is maybe the curvature, but also part is the fact that we've gone around a corner as well that way, so and that's probably the main reason. So let's get up here just for oxygen's sake and get back to moving these guys. Once we get to the point where they're going to be sliding down the hill, we'll be fine at least. It never, even though the sun does come up and set and stuff, it never really feels like day here. It's always kind of a, it's more of a, like a twilight kind of feeling, or like a kind of a winter's day, where, you know, it never really feels as if it gets, you know, as bright as you'd want it to be. Now let's get ourselves some over towards some oxygen. Let's put that down. No point in suffocating just because we're carrying that thing. Okay. We're getting towards the end of the time that I normally spend on an episode here, but I don't want to leave you on a cliffhanger, so I am definitely going to open these before we end the episode. Oh, that was not helpful. Okay. Okay, now you can maybe start rolling down. Okay, there we go. At least they went some way down the hill. And that red one is still going as well. Okay. And let's transfer them over closer to the research station. I'd love to play some multiplayer of this game, but unfortunately the people that I know who have the game, who record, are Morgix and Braskus, and they're already doing a series together, so I can't really gatecrash their series. There's some lithium, that's nice. And let's get the red one that for no particular reason I have a good feeling about, even though it should just be some resources. Yep, there we go. So some compound. So whatever the good feeling was, apparently it had something to do with compound. Was kind of hiding a bit, and then there's some resin. So resource wise, we're not really suffering here. We do have to wait for the sun to come back up. While we're doing that, let's grab some lithium. Well, okay, and then let's drop off some of the malachite over there, and the other ones, I'm going to put the other ones on the ground for now, and the reason for that is because if I put them in before I started, it would smelt the extra ones and still only give me one copper in return, so it wouldn't really be worth having them there. And let's grab this guy over there as well. Let's grab our copper out of the way. That one over there, and then put some more malachite there. Go back on there, please. Okay, let's stop getting distracted by the malachite and get back to our research. Okay, so this should be some more. Okay, so it's resin, yeah. Some more resources. Okay, now these are the ones that were crossing our fingers for. Okay, and then it's an aluminium from that one. How about this guy? And then it's a lithium from him. So maybe we're gonna have to go a bit further afield for what we want. For now, I'm going to come here to the printer, put in the lithium, and grab us another battery. Because that's going to be useful in ensuring that we don't run out of power as easily as we did previously. Let's get that malachite on the go. Oh, or let's just strip it off by accident. Here we go. So that's going to do there. And then that does bring us to the end of this particular episode. So if you have enjoyed, please consider liking, subscribing, and posting a comment. And really do hope to see all of you next time. Goodbye.